What do you mean? Oh, yeah. What was your character name? No, character name. D-U-F-O. And... Nice! Let's go. Alright. So we have 4 stocks left, right? Yeah, so we have 4 left. And they have, what player are they on? Aiden took out 1. Okay, so they're at 3. So we're winning right now by 1 stock. All right, you got to give Miss Beers your 3 bands, okay? All right. All right. All right. So go to the first.
Oh, okay. Hello. We need to make that a little louder. Hello.
All right. We're coming in here to Jess versus Gibbles.
Banjo versus Ganondorf.
Yeah. I think we're going to switch these off. Yeah, he jumped. I guess it really doesn't impact.
It really just impacts them because you plan to hit them.
That's a good edge, bud. You see that?
Avoid getting hit while he's in. There you go.
Alright, and we have our last player. It is now 3-2. 2 points for Green Valley and 3 points for MRH. Seeing Emery come in. All right. Who are you going in as? All right. All right. All right, so we got Gibbles versus Emery. I spelled that wrong. Don't tell Emery. They will beat me up. It was Emery again. All right. Emery is coming in here versus Gibbles. We have 2 stocks to 3 stocks. So good luck, Emery. Elliot, you told me to text your parents?
Yeah.
Okay.
You chose this state, and now you get to suffer. Because you don't get to have fun anymore. Home state. Why are you thinking the green leaves?
All right. So, Gibbles will have to SD once here before we can actually get started with it. We do have an advantage here in that we have an extra stock on Gibbles, but Ganondorf is one of those characters that only takes a few shots to knock somebody off stage. Good playing by Gibbles, could still come back and win this one. Emery has been practicing a lot of Pyramitha, though, so with some neutral airs and some fast-moving attacks, Emery could definitely has the advantage character-wise versus Ganondorf. Now we'll see you with execution. Just waiting on Gibbles to join the arena. All right, we are in. So Ganondorf, waiting for those invincibility frames. And now as our character, who's jumping in too early. All right, some good movement here. Some dominant use of special abilities and really dominating the air. Not giving Ganondorf a lot of movement here to breathe. Ooh, goes for the down air. Both characters missed their big attack. Ganondorf able to recover from that, but not able to get on stage. Some excellent ledge guard into the up air. That is going to be the first stock there. Gibbles is down to 1 stock, but at 80% there. Into the charged air attack. Should have shielded there. Should have shielded. And now it is 1 stock to 2 stocks. Emery with a huge advantage here. Ganondorf at 40%, 46%, 64% off stage, unable to recover. Oh, there we go. He's back on, and we see the pyro come out. Ganondorf well into kill range. Oh, goes for the shadow punch, but misses. Same thing from Emery there with the down up air. And another one hits, does not hit full force, though, so we don't see all the damage comes out. Ooh, unfortunate up B there. I always do that as Ganondorf. And Ganondorf now at 128%. Oh, and that's going to be game. MRH clutching game one in our two-set series. You will see game two coming here in a second. Thank you so much for joining us.
So round one here, we're going to see Valandar up against Buff. We got Akazia versus Piranha Plant. So Valandar's been putting in the work since this season. They're coming to us from Rocket League, and were pretty dominant with that team last year. But we unfortunately did not have a Rocket League this team this year, and we're very thankful. Valandar is coming over to us for Smash. And the game has started. We see Piranha Plant trying to get some movement, but equal percents here by both. Oh, brutal smash there by Kazuya. Avoids both those attacks. Piranha Plant's such a hard character to play around because he just plays differently than everybody else.
Ooh, got hit by Patooie. He seems to like going in Patooie then side going.
Ooh, nice down B. Avoids it. Both players at 90, the 90s, could go either way. Thankfully was able to get back on.
One could get, ooh,
an up smash there is gonna take the first stock of set two here.
Any good hit from Kazuya could possibly get Beefman out of here.
We see a lot of really good movement here. Oh, that shield break. Charge it up. Oh, and there goes Piranha Plant. We are tied back up here. What a game here by Valandar and Piranha Plant. Good recovery there on the side. Waiting to get, avoiding the spike shell. Jumps over, gets in there, lands an attack. Oh, unable to follow up with the combo though, but good set of moves there from Kazuya. Piranha Plant trying to dominate some of that attack.
Piranha Plant really likes doing Patooie, especially on edge and...
It gives Piranha Plant a lot of flexibility here. It's really hard to move around that. Thankfully, ooh, not hit. Been hitting a lot.
Rod Plant's always so weird with its little neck stretch thing, because it can do it at any angle, basically.
And it's got huge range, too. But our Kazuya has been doing a great job of anticipating.
Get it? Good.
Oh, unfortunate side dodge there, but was able to really dominate, predict all of Rod Plant's moves there to get back on stage. Oh, hits with the down B. Rod Plant is in death range now. One good attack and...
Ooh, getting closer.
Blocks. Piranha Plant, just one attack here from death. Nice combo there. Almost got it. Oh, connects with it. He's living!
He lives!
That was some good patience there by Piranha Plant to come in and take Kazuya off. And now we have set two. Looks like we'll be putting in Jess Gore. All right.
Got to
see.
Well, he's great at being aggro. Definitely seeing them shut it would be some good things for him.
Yeah.
Like when that Piranha Plant hit him from behind.
Yeah. All right. Going into set two here. Our round. I'm not muted. All right. Got Jess Gore versus Buff. So what are your thoughts right now, Emery? What are you thinking?
With Piranha Plant's Patooie being fairly good at hitting, as well as its weird little angle neck thing, I don't know what that's called, but I'll figure it out. I'm just going to call it a
charge attack. Charge attack.
Close enough.
Yeah, Piranha Plant's charge attack.
Based with how good they are with that, which is mainly Piranha Plant's whole thing, I could definitely see if the dodging's well enough, that Jess could possibly take either another stock or both stocks off. But it really depends how well the dodging is.
Yeah, he does. The Piranha Plant does do a really good job of.
Piranha Plant also seems to be very fast with zoning. Reaction.
Yeah. Well, Piranha Plant doesn't seem too fast with the reaction. Just really
zoning
good.
Zoning in.
Yeah, zoning. Forcing their his opponents to come in to him. Alright, some nice aggressive moves here by Banjo trying to get in versus that Piranha.
But lots of jabs. Yeah, a lot of nairs and jabs from Piranha Plant. Oh, that was almost death for Piranha. That would have been great.
Piranha's got a huge recovery.
Unfortunate
SD there by Banjo. Ooh! Down B into a smash attack. Almost kills off that. Oh.
Ooh. Oh.
Recovers. Nice recovery there. Another smash attack. Almost takes him out again, but he's still living.
Through the Batui gets hit. Ooh.
And that's going to do it. Nice job.
Good wing.
Piranha Plant down another stock here. Can we take one more?
Ooh.
Banjo's losing.
Yes.
Banjo's living.
Oh. Ooh.
Got to find a way past that.
Batui is really good with aim. They're really good with Batui aiming.
Ooh, back here is going to take it. Now we're down to our last stocks for both players here.
Good smash attack. Avoided Batui into a hit. Batui again. Ooh, good zoning. Into a Batui. That's not good. Hit with their own Batui, that's good. Using Batui against them.
Some good shields by this Piranha Plant. Seems to cover a lot of their bases. Oh,
whoa.
That doesn't kill.
Let me get back, let me get back.
That does, though.
Oh, maybe
nope,
not.
Nope.
Like Pete, you can send him to heaven, you can send him to hell, you can send him to purgatory, but to come back, oh, no, not this time. No.
All right. Good match there by Banjo-Kazooie. We'll be going into our third player. Who wants to finish this Piranha Plant off?
I've always lose against Piranhas. It's either you or Kendon.
All right.
Who went against the Piranha the last time?
Jed.
I'll go.
No, last time who went against Piranha. I think it was Kendon.
Kendon, you want to finish it off?
Yeah.
Okay. Aiden, you doing okay, bud?
Yeah.
Yeah. Try and see if you can stay for matches, but if you gotta go, you gotta go. It's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's all good.
All right. If not, me or Elliot could jump in.
All right.
It really depends.
Okay. So who's going in?
Kendon.
Okay. I know if I go against Prom Plant, I will stop.
Jess.
All right, we have Cookie Master finished, going to hopefully finish off the Piranha Plant. And so, we have Hero versus Piranha. Piranha has to jump off twice. They should not restart. Jump off and restart. Because they should not have hit you at all. Bee Plant thinking a bit too aggressively today. A bit too aggressive. Not good. So, our fighter is going to restart the match. Piranha Plant's going to SD twice, like he's supposed to. And it's going to be nice and friendly. And hopefully Pea Plant's not too aggressive again. He's being too aggressive. Oh, they have to restart because Piranha hit before SD.
They're on different sides again. I don't know why they keep switching like that.
Because you switched the two before. All right. Good hits in. Ooh. Avoids Patooey. Makes it to stage. Good. Piranha really reading coming back on edge. Ooh. Good. Avoids Patooey. Good dodge. Ooh. Hero 87%. 107 dead.
Ooh, and there's our first stop.
And Piranha Plant's gone. Yippee. Now let's see who our two stock hero is going against next.
About what? What she messaged you. Oh. Yeah,
Graham, after Pea Plant, they have 12 stock left. Yeah.
Oh, sure. She just letting you know she dealt with it. What'd you say?
After Pea Plant's dead, they have 12 stocks left because they were at 13.
Yep.
Okay. I was double checking.
Okay, so we're Banny.
Who's the player?
Chuckles. I don't know the fiber yet.
Chuckles. Chuckles the clown? Oh no, not the clown! Alright, we have Chuckles King as King K. Rool and Cookie Master at two stocks on Hero. Let's see if we can beat up the King of the Swamp at the Bayou. Good hits in.
Some good early pressure there from Hero.
Fairly even percentages.
Yeah, but we are down four stocks, though, so it is going to be quite an uphill battle for us to come back and win this. But if anybody could do it, it's Cookie Master.
Indeed. Ooh.
Ooh, avoids the attack. Good mashing. Ooh, the crit!
Good hit.
You know, in our first state championship, we had the state champion at the time playing up against Hero, and they picked Hero for that RNG crit. And it paid off for us. We still ended up winning.
RNG Jesus. Because.
Oh, that offstage guarding. He goes up too early. And no! Cookie Master punishes. Let's go.
Let's see if we can finish off that K-roll on its last stock. We'll be good if we can. Hopefully get them to our level of stocks. Good snooze.
Go to sleep.
Psych up. Oh. Makes it backstage. Good hits. K. Rool on 120.
Waiting out that psych up. Good move there by King K. Rool. You know, we have not seen this King K. Rool use any of his
projectiles.
Yeah.
Until now.
But even then, they were just using it for an edge guard. Ooh, and the hits it. Cookie Master.
Cookie Master tying this game up almost. Three stocks off.
One.
Sorry.
Yeah. So it's now 7-9. Cookie Master coming back, bringing four stocks home for us. Still down by two, though. How do you think things are going so far, Emery?
I think that it's going to go fairly well. While we may be low on stocks, I think that depending how well Hero can go up against the next person, as well as how well Infinite and me can go up against whoever's next, kind of settles who's going to win this.
We have Jibbles with a J.
Jibbles. Jibbles is the problem.
I think he was the cloud.
Jibbles is the problem.
I don't know yet. He has his head.
All right. So,
Jibbles of the Giblets. Is he the cloud? Is he going cloud? He's going to be against
cloud. Captain Falcon.
Cap Falcon?
Falcon.
He's trying to be pro Falcon?
Any Kalos Pokemon moves?
He's trying to be pro Falcon, I guess.
All right. Emery, you do some casting outside of this, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay, you should put your gamer tag in there so people can follow you.
I should. Caster.
Press the ST. There you go.
Alright.
Looks like we're getting ready to start.
And I'm gonna put the door. Bunk. So.
Just waiting on one of them to press the start button, I think.
Indeed.
Sure, go ahead.
Nope.
It's her. Why are they K-Rool?
What's going on?
They're sure the King K. Rool.
Jibbles, you're supposed to be Captain Falc. All right, we got the Captain Falcon, Jibbles, going against Hero, Cookie Master. 7-9 stocks.
Look like we're switched again, so it's...
No?
Yep, see, Hero's blue.
That's cool. It seems to switch every time.
All right.
Hero has to SD twice, I believe.
No, just go ahead and we'll restart the match. Alright, so, I think win condition this time. Ooh, who actually won that one?
Hawaii.
Oh, it was a sudden death! Oh my gosh!
First time ever going to sudden death.
That was pretty funny. Hadn't seen that before. Alright, Cookie Master comes out on top though by SDing first. Yeah. So it's going to be a hard match here for for Cookie Master to come up on top here, but if any stocks he can take reduces that lead on Grain Valley and gives us more.
It could be that they might have their controls. Yeah.
Could might be the wrong stage, too.
They have the bomb controllers. That's why he asked Steve.
Good See? Thing she knows the rule now.
It's a valid
mic's on.
Reason.
Yeah. So, yeah. Yeah, so we're restarting. Grain Valley had the wrong controls on.
But it's all right. Hopefully we won't go to the sudden death this time. That was a surprise screen. Just see both of them.
I feel like they should have played that out.
That would have been funny, but
winner
no.
takes all. I only say that because we were down two stocks. Yeah. All right, so Hero's going to SD twice. And then we'll get this match started.
Where's your flare? Where's the flare? You have no flare.
He's got the drip though. Look at Hero.
He may have the drip, but he doesn't.
Oh, you see that spacing and the crit? Oh my gosh, this Hero is not messing around. Hero came to play. Oh, that offstage ledge guard right there was absolutely beautiful.
76% for. Oh, there he goes. Hero decided to go visit heaven for a bit, I guess.
Oh, was that a spot dodge? That was. Oh, and then we got our first stock at 23%. We've got a dream here. Can we go with the three stock
Can
and take the lead?
Go through with it.
Ooh, hit. Look, let's go.
Hero got some RNG over here.
Hits boom. Is that gonna kill?
Oh, maybe.
And there's the second stock. It's tied up now, 7-7.
Maybe we can get
and another crit. Oh my gosh, this Hero is just built different.
I don't think Captain Falcon knows how to fight against heroes. Oh, maybe a little.
All right, tied, but one stock left for both players.
But at the same time, I think it might just be
Hero
your
is now in kill
RNG.
Percent.
Oh, RNG!
Oh my goodness!
The RNG
there we go.
The RNG is strong in this one.
He's taking the lead.
The RNG is strong in this one.
That was awesome. Did you see how many grits I got?
That was insane.
The RNG is strong in this one.
As my grandma would say, you must have been praying. Because that was... Yes. You must have been living your life right.
Now we need to see who's coming next. All right, we have, I'm going to call him Radius because I don't know how to say his name, but, oh, they stole Jess's Banjo-Kazooie color.
Yep.
I guess we're going against Jess now, I guess, but,
Cookie Master is going to SD twice, then we'll get this started. MRH is now in the lead by one stock. Any stocks that Cookie Master can take, just add to our lead now, so... Good luck to both players here. But more to Cookie Master.
Indeed. And hope that we can beat up this Jess knock off a Banjo Kazooie because they colors. We love colors. Kazooie looks so wrong in green.
Both characters playing pretty safe right now.
Keeping fairly similar percentages too.
Oh, we see Hero having that lead.
Banjo Kazooie really likes using its jumps into down A.
Ooh, crit! And there
RNG.
We go.
Can Hero do it yet again?
Let's see. Heal? All right, they're tied on stocks again.
Not stocks, tied on a percent. Ooh, get back. Ooh, just barely.
What a nice recovery there.
Good hit. Does not kill.
Alright! Another stock! Can he take the third one? We will see here in a second. Though it will only take about one little poke for, and that will do it.
There it goes.
Alright.
That was great, though.
Yeah. So we were at 12 stocks, and now they're down to 5. So Kendon took 7 stocks. Let's go. This kid is built different.
I'm gonna head up.
You don't want to stay for the rest of the match? All right, so we have Emery coming in here. Kendra, tell me about that 7-stock run right there. What were you thinking about?
So that game went pretty good, actually. I did not expect to get that many crits, and I did not expect to get that lucky.
Yeah, how did you get that many crits? Did you pay off the Smash Gods?
Nope.
Did a little $20 to the Smash creator right there?
So it's all about the skill.
Okay, and we'll get into this game right here. So Emery has just got to take 1 stock in order to move us into their last player. We've got Elliot up on deck to hopefully finish this off as well. So how does this match play up? What's Pyramithra going to focus on here?
Well, I feel like she should stick as Mithra, but if things get a little dicey, she should play Pyra.
Oh, look at Mithra right there trying to be flashy. Platform got in the way. Banjo-Kazooie.
We had to do a little reset here due to controls.
Due to controls. Yeah.
Let me free.
Yeah. I think also the key here for Pyramithra 2 is just avoiding that side charge, that flap. I don't know what you call it. What do you call the...
I don't know what to call that either.
I'm going to call that the charge. The Banjo-Kazooie charge.
Yeah.
So, all right. It looks like they might be starting up here again. All right. Got the right name. All right.
You want to cast? Okay. All right, so Banjo is going to start by SDing twice, and then the match will get started.
All right, let's go up Pyromithra.
All right, match could start. Ooh, side B does not get through it. Look at those aerials. Pyromithra has been working on those aerials, and oh my gosh, the short hop, that is brutal right now. I'm so proud. Are you proud? I know I'm proud.
Yeah, I'm proud too.
Ooh, avoids the charge attack. Mixing up some attacks there. Multiple play styles now. Oh, Banjo-Kazooie's in kill percent. Oh my gosh! The neutral guards there by this Pythra.
Nice recover. Oh,
almost.
Missed it.
Need to change back to...
at the wrong time.
All right. Banjo is in kill percent range.
Just one smash hit could kill him. Ooh, that side.
No.
Down air. On the edge of my seat right now here.
Me too. Oh.
All right, so now we know. Charge flappy thing wins over.
Over Uppy.
Over Uppy. The footstool.
Not the footstool.
Yeah! And there we go, and that's gonna finish it off. Let's go, Emery.
Let's go, Emery. Let's go.
All right. So press the ST.
ST. This.
Mhm. Yep. And then we're going to update them to 3. And we're going to update us to 4. Okay.
The beat of my music changed, and that's what messed me up. All
right, then we're going to delete Rathius.
I forgot what play was open.
Do we know their last character's name?
Invivable.
Stage bands? Click on the banjo.
Huh?
Click on the banjo.
If only I was better tonight. Three. That would have been a fun little
update.
Battle.
I love your Pyromithra. That was awesome.
Where are the stairs?
Okay. And you can go ahead and press gameplay.
Funny haha little.
All right.
Canonical battle. Oh, he even flashed Kirby. That would have been perfect. Flash bang for Kirby.
All right, we got Pyromithra versus a Kirby.
I know.
Yeah. So we're going to start off this one by Pyromithra jumping off twice.
Just once. Just once, because she only got one time.
She only got it once?
Yeah.
Oh.
I want this one.
She almost got twice.
Gotcha. All right.
One thing?
Go ahead. We're seeing some good gameplay here. Both characters just trying to feel out the other one. All right.
Trying to find some openings. Green Valley knows that this is their last chance here. Ooh, some nice combo attacks there. Switches the Pyro, get that off. We see Kirby almost in kill percent here. What is kill percent for Pyromithra? 60?
Pyro's kill percent could be up to 60 to like 90.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh,
but not killed.
And just barely finds the corner there to survive that.
Ooh, miss.
Kirby with those multiple jumps.
But not killed again.
All right. Both players have pretty high percents now. Ooh, Kirby getting the charge off there. Kirby now up to 100. Oh, that killed.
Oh, that killed.
That's Look fine. At that. We have 2-5 now. Green Valley on their last two stocks. Can Emery close this game out? Guess we'll see in a second. Oh, that down B there. And we see Emery there losing her down to her last stock. Almost kills off
almost
that.
Almost killed.
Alright. Kirby now up to 113. Just gotta tap him now, he's gonna be dead.
Ooh, nice spike.
Pyromithra special moves are just brutal sometimes.
Ooh, that was close, but not full.
And that's going to kill
Let's
again.
Kill. Let's go.
Last stock.
Last stock for the opposing team. Crap. I forgot my stock. Oh, wait. We're good. Yeah. All right.
Gets the down B. Into the up B. Starting to stack that percentage on Pyromithra, but it's still pretty low. It's anybody's game right now.
Yeah. If Emery lose, we still have one person on full three stocks, so we might win this.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Connects with a side B. Into some short hop aerials. Into another side B. Kirby on his last stocks. Ooh, is that going to kill?
No, unfortunately not.
Final Destination must be a big stage.
Yes, it is. It's my favorite, too.
That's going to kill, though, and that is the game.
That's the game. Let's
go!
MRH.
How
did I manage? Who did
that? And that's game. MRH wins.
Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And I hope you guys all have a great day.
See ya.